This video presents Reflectance Channel enhancements used by ARCHICAD's built-in CineRender engine. By using this channel improvement, more photorealistic reflectance settings can be applied to reflective surfaces. This sphere currently does not have any reflective properties. Let's see some surface settings options available to enhance the reflectance channel. This is a simple gray surface. Let's display the reflectance panel. We will add a new layer here. Let's have a closer look at the anisotropic option. Notice that there are plenty of options available to fine-tune this channel. Let's select the layer anisotropy option. We'll select the planar option for reprojection at the top. This will provide a metallic effect for the surface. Let's select the circular option for pattern and increase the anisotropy value. We will decrease the scale value. Let's render the scene below to see how these settings affect the final rendering. Please notice the unique brushed metal look of the ground. Surfaces like this can be used in kitchen counters and kitchen equipment. Let's continue and select the Beckman type from the list. We'll enter 0 for the width roughness value. This will provide a more mirror-like surface finish. Other recommended options for further fine-tuning are the reflection strength and layer color. For instance, if we decrease the brightness value here, the reflective effect will be less visible. Please note that all the effects have a dedicated texture channel. Let's learn how to use the texture channel for layer masks. We can specify a procedural tile texture here. This will add a color for texture for the mask of the reflectance shader. We won't need this effect for now, so let's switch it off. We can also specify a texture for layer color. Let's see what happens if we select a checkerboard procedural texture here. The preview provides instant feedback about the results. Let's continue with the width roughness option. We'll specify the very same checkerboard procedural texture here as before to see the results. By increasing the roughness value, we can adjust the amount of reflectance. Let's adjust the frequency value as well. Let's have a look at the results of these adjustments by creating another rendered image. Please notice that the ground surface has an interesting reflective texture. Another option is to turn on the distance dim option. This will limit the effect of the reflecting elements. Let's enter 6,000 mm for the distance value because we would like the top of the vertical wall reflected, but nothing above that. Let's render the image again with the new settings. Notice that the reflectance effect has been reduced in relation to the distance. Another improvement is that it's now possible to add multiple reflectance channels. In this example, we will add a Beckman and also a Fong reflectance layer. Let's start by adjusting the Beckman shader. Let's increase its width roughness value to 40, and notice how this setting affects the preview. The reflectance effect has been decreased. Now we can use the blend option to unify the two layers. Here we'll enter 50 for the amount in order to achieve a more natural look for the end result. This will result in a reflecting metal surface that has a slight water vapor on it. Let's render the scene. Notice the slight foggy effect on the final image. Let's continue and see how to apply bump effects. Let's delete the layer created earlier, and also specify normal blend mode and set the amount to its default value. Let's display the bump strength panel. Here we can adjust the strength of the bump channel, but we may also specify a custom bump map. This may be fully independent from the other bump settings of the surface. Let's select a simple noise texture and slightly decrease its strength. Please note that we did not activate the bump option of the surface. We only applied the bump effect to the reflectance characteristics. Let's render the scene again. Notice that the reflectance of the ground surface has been modified.